Hey Boils and Ghouls, I'm back, and I thought I'd do just like a get ready with me like chatting video, just cause I'm gonna be recording some other videos for my other channel, which if you haven't checked out, you definitely should if you like video games or anything considered nerdy. So I already did my eyebrows just cause I'm like really finicky and sometimes it takes like upwards of like 5 minutes. Sorry, not 5 minutes. It takes upwards of like 15 minutes to do them. So I thought I'd just explain kind of how I do my eyebrows, and then maybe I'll do an eyebrow video another time. But I use Anastasia's Dip Brow Pomade in Medium Brown, which is like, look at, I hit pan on it. But as you can see, my eyebrows are definitely black. So I had used to use just this when I had like blonde hair, or if I, well, I think I only have blonde hair, but I got it because I like changed my hair color quite often, so I'd be like purples and blues and stuff, and I thought that like having black eyebrows might not look as nice. I was like, maybe if I had brown eyebrows it would just be not as like crazy, especially with my blonde hair. So I used this, and then I realized that it really wasn't working, and that I still kind of ended up just look like I drew brown over my eyebrows. I mean, it worked and it was okay, but it wasn't the best. So I used this to sculpt out my shape, and then I go over it with the black, one of the blacks from my first, what is this? It's the first edition 120 color palette from BH Cosmetics. So I go over that with black. So yeah, I just thought I would do kind of a little chat with me while I get ready to film other videos. So yeah, how's everyone doing? I'm doing pretty good. Working right now on getting a job and filling out some paper, not paperwork, filling out my testimonial for church and some other stuff. So that's what I've been up to. I'm using the NYX HD concealer because it's like the best thing in the world. And I put it on any marks, and then I also put it on my cheeks because they tend to be a little red. I sometimes dab it on places that sometimes get red. I know you can't really see how red I am, but at least I don't think you can. And then I think it works as a really good eyeshadow base. So, get gold looking like this. Looking ridiculous. So, yeah, I have a lot to do today. I have to film this video. And then I have to film, I'm gonna try and film a few more. And then edit at least this one, and then one for my other channel. So, yeah. So if you haven't checked it out yet, me and my boyfriend started this like video gaming channel thing. And so most of the time we just play Sims and what else? Plague. But we also have Mod Mondays or Tuesdays, which is when he talks about like video game mods, mostly for Fallout 3, and then I do Nerdy Tea Time. What is it? Nerdy Tea Time on Wednesdays. So I have to record that and edit it today because we haven't had internet, so we haven't been able to like post anything. So kind of got a little lazy with recording. So I was like, oh, I can't record anything because I can't post it till Wednesday. And now I have to record a whole bunch of stuff and post it all today. So I have to edit it today too. Luckily, my videos aren't very long. So yeah, I always do that before I use eyeshadow. And I think I'm gonna do I'm gonna use yellow today because I really like yellow. I think I'm gonna use yellow. I did this, I'm gonna do a similar eyes look to one I did recently, I think. If I can get this open, otherwise I won't. There we go. Should I use that? Ooh, no, let's use green. So I think I'm gonna start with that one right there. So, yeah. And I know I said I was gonna, oh, where's my towel? I was gonna put up a video about my, like, coming back to Christ and everything, and I just haven't gotten around to it. But I will do that before my baptism, hopefully. So, well, hopefully. I mean, my baptism isn't for like another month, so Although, I don't know. Sometimes I'm not the best with posting videos. I mean to be. I'm just not. So, I'm just gonna put this all over the lid, I think. And I finally got this whole thing figured out, I think, for filming, so that's good. And it's good because it works for filming this, and then it also works for filming, nerdy tea time. Nerdy talk tea time, or something like that. I cannot remember for the life of me what it's called. Oops. Do you ever dip it in the wrong color? You're like, no! I mean, it's not that big of a deal. You just wipe it off. And as for the brush I'm using, I'm just using one of the brushes I got when I went to school. It's by Kala, whatever, however you pronounce that. Just like a regular eyeshadow brush, so nothing special. And if you're wondering what I use to prime, I use the NYX primer. And then I mix it in with, it's called Repoussoir or whatever, and it's from when I went to aesthetic school again. And it's just a face cream. Just to, you know, put back any moisture on my face. Especially because I know this one's going to sound really weird, but I don't like creams or lotions and stuff. Like, I'm not really big on, like, I'm not one of those people that, like, carry hand lotion with me everywhere I go. I'm just not. But, so the way to do it so that I can moisturize my face is if I put it in primer, then I'll do it. But otherwise, I don't go out of my way to, like, do that. Oh my goodness. Cat hair everywhere. Cat owner problems. I love him, but he, like, drives me nuts. I'm sorry, it's so hot in here. One second. There we go. Get some heat and some air in here because it's, like, boiling in my room because the door's shut. Okay, so then I'm going to use one of the colors from my, it's called the 28 color palette neutral eyeshadows from BH Cosmetics. I'm gonna use this one right here. Oop, you can't even see it. This one. In the crease. So, I'm just gonna blend that into the crease. And down onto the lid a little bit. So, yeah. Blend that out a bit more. So how many of you guys like scary movies? Just question. I watched Insidious 1 with my sister, because I used to date this guy, and he liked horror movies, and I liked horror movies. So I went to horror movies together. And now we don't date anymore, so I was like, I have no one to go to horror movies with. So I started creaming my sister to like them. So we watched Insidious last weekend, and then we watched Insidious, and we watched The Conjuring. And it's really funny. If I can, you know what, I might add some video. Of her screaming. And, like, I don't mean just, like, like, screaming. And so, it was very fun that weekend to scare her. Which is funny, because I actually hate being scared. Like, hate it. Like, if someone scares me, I'll kill them. But, I like scaring other people. This is just a clean brush. And it looks like there's, like, a lot of shadow here, but I think that's just the... Let me see. A little bit. But not a lot. Ugh. But it, yeah. Anyway. So, I've been getting ready for, like, liking those movies and stuff and, like, going to see them and stuff with me in theaters. Because I am a huge horror movie fan. I'm just gonna smack myself in the face. I'm gonna take this one right here. On this brush. Because I don't like going to see them by myself. I mean, who likes to go see horror movies by themselves? Maybe there's some people. I don't. But. And I'm just going to kind of bring it down a little bit onto the lid so that it kind of mutes the green out just a little bit so it's not as crazy bright. And then another thing I like to do is take my foundation. Because I started using Sephora powder foundation in the color medium, so 30, because I don't like my acne's slowly clearing up finally, so I don't need like that thick of a foundation, so just use this. But and I take it on a brush and I use it to kind of like blend out the edges a bit. You can hear that's my cat. Just kind of it's weird because it looks completely different than it does here, so might have to add in some pictures. To turn on this light, which is gonna kind of look a little, there we go. It takes a while for it to kind of, just so I can see the color a bit better, because it's being a little weird today. I actually filmed a Get Ready With Me, like a silent one, and then I hated it. I watched the film and I was like, this is terrible, so that's why it didn't get posted. Well, and because I had internet. Ooh, what's that? Oh, it's my iPad. Okay, anyway. So, yeah, I think I'm going to take a little bit of black. And just along there. Can you hear him? Then I always go in with this one to kind of blend it all together. Mm-hmm. It looks way more blended here than it does on there, which is really weird. Here, let me see if I can fix that. No, I don't think I can. Weird, because it's like, it's a little bit, oh, I guess you can kind of see, but, yeah. So it is blended. It may not look 100% blended, but it is. Hopefully that's a little bit better now. You can see it. I guess the room and my light was off. So that's a little silly. Let's try this one again. No, weird. Okay. I'll post some pictures after you can see my eyes a little bit better. One day, I will get proper lighting in here. Nope. I have this weird, like, mirror thing that has different lights on it. I don't know. I guess we'll just go with this one and see what happens. So, yeah. Bring some more of that brown, that first brown on this brush, a little bit down onto the lid, just a little bit more. Also, I have kind of weird eyes, so unless I'm looking at, like, a certain angle, sometimes it just, like, I don't know, you can only see parts of it, so it looks like this and this are, like, not blended, because you can't always see my crease, but, yeah, so. I'll just take that blender brush and blend it out again. And most of these brushes are all from my school, or these fancier ones are cute. Oh, it's not Duo, it's like with a Q though. Q-O, Q, I don't know. It's from Shoppers Drug Mart. I don't know, I got it for my birthday, so. Yeah. So. I think I'm done for the eyeshadow on the top. Now I'll take my Maybelline Line Stiletto. I thought this was a pen, and it's not. I was grumpy about it, but, well, it kind of is a pen, but it's not like what I wanted. It's like this. I mean, it's pretty sharp, I guess, but it's not what I wanted, and it makes putting on eyeliner slightly difficult, so. Forgive me. See, and then I just gotta keep adding, and eventually I end up with big, thick, and like internal rage, but. There we go. One partially done. I don't do the whole thing until I've done the other one. Just because, I don't know, I find it easier to match that way. Maybe I'm weird, though. No, one's bigger than the other, of course. So, this is the fun part of eyeliner. And I love liquid eyeliner, but I just lately have been having such issues with it. Definitely bigger than that one, but I like it, I think. So. Yeah. I don't know if you can tell. But I kind of like Spider-Man. In the background there, you can see my Spider-Man calendar that's like for like a 4-year-old. But I have some friends. Taylor Ewing and Stephanie. I cannot feel like I remember their name, but I'll put the pictures up, because I asked, I was like, if anyone wants to draw me with Spider-Man, that would be awesome. And they did, and they're so good, and I just love them for doing that, and I love the pictures. Roughly-ish the same. So now I'm just gonna fill in this part of this eye. And then I probably won't play with it too much more just because you're always like, you know what, I'll just do it a little bit more and it won't make that much of a difference, and next thing you know, your entire eyelid is covered in black eyeliner. person that can't really, like, talk while they're putting makeup on. Like, I can talk in between, but, like, I don't know, something just, like, shuts me up. I don't know. It's probably tight line. See, I like tight lining, I just, like, almost never remember to do it. Let that dry a little bit, and then I'll tight line, because it gets all of my fingers up in my face, and then I'll end up with highlighter all over my fingers, so that'll be happy. And then I'm obsessed with this thing that I've been doing lately. I take the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in White, and I know this isn't something I've invented or anything. Like, I know, like, a lot of people do this, but I'm just obsessed with doing it. And then I put it in my waterline. And then, oh wow, it looks really bright on cam. There we go. And then I'll take, let's see, what color should we do? Let's do a dark green. Or let's do this one. We're going to do this green, right? Right here. It's like a bluey green. Oh, and I just got my nail all in it. Awesome. And I take it on this brush, which I don't know where I got this one from. I think this is another... Yeah, this brand. QUO. Oh, you can't even see it. Oh. No, you can't see it. It's an eyeliner smudger brush, but I take this one, and then I just, like, put it in the product, tap it off, and then run it along the bottom part of my eye. This is my favorite look ever. If you follow me on Instagram, you know this already, because you see, like, every picture is, like, with this. I know what you're thinking. It's looking a little crazy. And that's because it is. It's looking a little crazy, and then I usually take this brush or, like, the other one and fluff out the bottom. And then we'll go in with this, and then we'll take a little bit of a brown color too underneath there, just to kind of, I don't know, it just adds like another dimension to it, I guess. Just right underneath the color. Can you hear the rain and stuff outside my window? I don't know where all you guys are from, but I'm from Alberta. Calgary, Alberta, and it's been, like, raining, like, non-stop, and it kind of sucks. So I'm just taking a light brown again, and just, I keep reminding myself not to be, like, when I put on makeup, because, I mean, it's an attractive face, I know, but, there we go, so, and then, I've also been obsessed with taking yellow for some reason. So we use, like, I use, like, a combination of all of, oops, okay, all of the yellows in the palette, kind of, like, on this side. I kind of mix them in and just go for it. And I put it in the corner of my eye. And I just think it looks fabulous. I just gotta make sure to blend it up into the eyeshadows that are already there. See, there you go again, making those funny faces. So there, like that. Let me just... There, like that. I feel like this is, like, more true to the colors, but, like, I can't see putting on makeup like that, so... After I'll take it off and chat with you. Oh, that's too many lights. Don't need to see me in that much that like a high definition. So wait, I have an idea. Let's see if this fixes the hole. Nope. Not at all. But this is like, isn't this great lighting? I freaking love this, my room. I used to hate it, but since I moved everything around because I had two dressers, now I have one. And I've always had my two bookshelves and then my bed and then this table. And then I have this like little side table where all my makeup sits. And I had my bed here where this is. And then I had my two dressers, my two bookshelves on that wall. And then I had this in front of those. And then I had another, what's it called? Dresser there. And then I had my dresser in my closet. So I downsized all my clothes, got rid of a whole bunch of stuff. And now I have one closet, my two bookshelves, and then my bed is over here. And so now there's like a whole bunch of space. And also I can do my light, my makeup right in the light. That's usually a lot better because it's usually sunny and shiny and you can see my face. But so, oh, is it gonna start raining on me? Yeah, close it just a little bit. Okay, so now I'm gonna take this again and sweep it underneath. Then I'm gonna go in with what color? There's this like, okay, I'm really careful doing this. This color, it's like a pearlescent, I guess, kind of. I don't know. It's like a white, but it's got like flecks of other stuff in it. And I'm gonna put that on the brow bone just to kind of highlight it. Sorry if this video is super long. I'm really bad at that, like cutting, like making videos super long when I'm talking, because I just like ramble on for forever. So, apologies in advance. So now that that's done, I'm gonna take my foundation now, and then again, just this one, and I take a beauty blender and I just like rub it in there and go to town. Now this is really weird, but I don't like using the brush because I feel like it doesn't get enough product. But I don't want it too heavy, like my foundations that I have, because I have, I have two from Elf. One is like more of a BB cream, but even that I found was too heavy, and I mixed it with like, cream to like try and make it like thinner, and I still found it like way too heavy and not enough coverage still at the same time. But this stuff covers up everything that I have, especially if I put on concealer first, and it doesn't feel heavy and it's really easy to apply. So, and I really like this method actually, because it like distributes quite a bit of, like, I feel like if I did this with a brush I'd just be like here for hours just like putting it on, but this just wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Right? And then since I'm doing filming, I want to make sure my under eyes are all nice and concealed. I don't know what this is, but, well, you know, like, no, I don't know where I was going with that. Oh, wow. Kind of like warrior-esque, I guess. A little bit down the bridge of my nose. A little on my chin. I don't really put any on the top of my lip because of my Medusa. So. Which is another video that I should do. Because I posted a video of like getting it, but I didn't really post a video of like me like talking about it. Oh no, you can't see. I was hoping you can see kind of like where I put it more, but you can't. I will figure out that light thing eventually. Thunder. I'm a big fan of Thunder, and so is my boyfriend. My sister, on the other hand, not so much. I'm trying to decide what kind of makeup I'm going to do for my sister's wedding. Getting married in like, I don't know, it's like September, so it's coming up soon, and I'm kind of trying to decide what look I want to go for. So then I have this Marc Jacobs contouring palette and it's Mirage Filter, and it's, yeah, so it's got, it's the number 40, it's, try and cover that for you guys, so it's the brown and the banana powder, whatever people call it. So, and then I just take it and set it. So I'm really bad at doing it on my nose. I just get it everywhere on my nose. And then I guess that we'll contour a little bit today. So I'll do my nose first. Because the one I'm worst at, so I'm going to take this brush and put in the brown color, which is sometimes gets all that white on it for some reason. The banana E color, sorry. I'm going to go down the sides of my nose. And I like to contour right here on my nose as well. That's my sister. Okay, I'm back. Sorry, apparently there's a tornado warning in Calgary, which, I mean, to some of you guys, it's probably like, eh, whatever. But, like, that happens here. But that doesn't happen here, so. So I'm just going to contour up a little bit. And then, big fluffy brush to kind of blend it out a bit. And then if I don't like something, if it's a little too heavy, then I just go in with my blending brush, my beauty blender, and I try to stick the brush in like this. Where's my brain? I'm obviously thinking about the fact that there could be a tornado. So, yeah. My nose, done. Looking fabulous. And then this big, I use this for both contouring and bronzer, just because basically I usually put them in the same area usually. I don't heavily contour usually, so just a little bit like that. Yeah, so if you hear my sister screaming and yelling at me, that's why. But she's keeping me in the loop on what's happening, because you see that? It looks like I have a weird mark. One sec. There we go. You don't really get tornadoes here, so. The fact that our house could be ripped apart or something like that is scary. But only somewhat scary, because we don't really get them, so I mean, a tornado warning is pretty crazy here, but the likelihood of it actually happening is, like, slim to none, so. Yeah, I don't do too much craziness, but then I go back over with one of my favorite duos of all time right now. It's the contour and blush. Contouring blush and bronzing powder from e.l.f. I don't think it has a name, like, other than that. So, I don't know if there's more than one, but it's like. Those colors. So. Yeah, and then I just kind of go over a little bit. I know I hold this weird, but I, like, can't, like this, to me, crushes my boobs. So, this is what it is. Well, then I'll take a little bit and right there. So, yeah, that's done. And then, I take the blush from this palette. I try to, like, mix it, like, blend it a little bit with the bronzer beneath it. So. Yeah. Crazy. There's a tornado. That'll be really scary. I don't want to have a tornado. My boyfriend's not home. after, like, the minute I'm done filming this, I'm gonna call him and make sure he's okay. He's at the church, which is, like, a 10-minute walk from here. But I don't want him to, like, be stuck out there with tornado. That's not safe. That's not cool. So, then I try to, like, clean up as I go. Oh, that doesn't go there. Otherwise, I just end up with, like, this mess of, like, all my brushes and stuff. Can you hear that? And it's, like, crazy raining outside. I'm like, there's thunder, which I like. But tornadoes I don't like. Well, I can assume. I've never been in a tornado, but I'm just gonna go out on a limb here and say, no tornadoes for me. So. But, yeah. So then I take my e.l.f. Volume Pumping Mascara, which is, like, amazing, and it's, like, really cheap. I think I got it for, like, $4, maybe. Maybe 8, so maybe double that. Oh my goodness, mascara for $8, but it's amazing for $8, so. Of course. Can't my makeup look complete unless I do that, pretty much. So the green on top kind of ended up a little bit muted, but that's okay. I like to do this with blue too. Blue and yellow look like perfect together. I'm actually super excited for my sister's wedding, like, as far as makeup goes, because I'm doing mine, my little sister, and my mom's makeup, and my little sister's hair. I don't know if you guys can hear that. I don't know if I just, like, look like I'm reacting to nothing, but that's, like, an intense sound. I mean, I'm not super worried about it again. We don't have tornadoes very often here, but. So yeah. Spooky. So yeah. So I put that on. Wipe my finger off so it's not my finger does not leave volume or lift. And then I don't do this always, but sometimes I take a little brow gel and just I don't do it always because it kind of depends if I'm, like, going out or not, but I'm not going out, but I'll do it just because. Just because why not? So, voila. There we go. So, see it a little bit better. So, yeah, I'll take some pictures, too, because sometimes, like, pictures get it a little bit better. And until I can figure out how I'm gonna set up my camera to pick up light and stuff. This is kind of the best I can do, but yeah, this is just filming today and hopefully not dying of a tornado. So, by me, by the time you watch this, if I'm dead, then I'm dead. Sorry. No more videos. Tornado got me, or if I'm in the Wizard of Oz, I'll vlog from there. Ooh, I should close my window, though. So, yeah, we're gonna go, because I gotta close my window and call my boyfriend and make sure that my house doesn't blow away. I mean, I don't know how I'm gonna do that. Just throw ropes over it and bam, our house won't blow away. Anyway, yeah, so thanks for watching, guys, and I'm gonna try and be more regular with uploading videos as much as I can and just keeping guys in the loop with my life and stuff, so. Yeah, and if you want to see more videos, then pop on over to my other channel and you can see my Sims, and you can see Nerdy Tea Time where I talk about movies and books and comics and TV shows that I like. So, thank you all for watching and have a good day!